it to this place explode here. Everybody on their feet to greet that man. In my book, the greatest professional athlete in the world today.
Lust Hogan.
Hulk is his name.
Lust.
You're obviously jealous, Jess.
You're darn right, because this guy is so underhanded, he wouldn't come to Macho face to face. He wouldn't say, Macho, I want a shot at the title. No, he has to go after Macho's woman. I had a manager in 81, Classy Freddie Blassie.
Yeah, and he took your career right down the toilet.
Oh, Dale's on once again. He's trying to frustrate the Hulkster.
Hey. This is like a cat and mouse game right here. This is just cat and mouse.
Oh, come on, give me a break. That's ridiculous and disgusting.
Oh,
he slammed it right over the top rope.
You know what? If I was Macho, I'd stay down for the count.
You would.
That way you keep your title.
He's got more integrity than that, Jess. Look at Elizabeth over there to help him.
Well, it's about time. It's about time she remembers her roots.
Oh, he doesn't want any help. Here it comes. Just like, what's this? Look at Elizabeth. Miss Elizabeth stepping right in front of him.
Oh, look at that. Hogan outsmarted himself.
She's not staying in a neutral corner. Oh, look at this, manhandling her once again. Sticking the finger in her face. She's backed up right to the barricade.
Whoa, savage deck and Hogan.
It looks like he wants a deck Miss Elizabeth too. He's shoving her back.
He's getting her away from ringside.
Referee Hebner right down there. Look at this. He just put Miss Elizabeth out.
Hebner, all right, he's getting rid of her. Macho going for the big drop on Hogan.
Oh,
he got him. And he drove him head first right into that steel railing, right across the throat.
A block and a right hand and another one.
I can't believe this is happening.
Was conducting an interview with Miss Elizabeth back in the dressing room area.
Out in the arena, we have just seen a new World Wrestling Federation champion crowd. He is Hulk Hogan. Elizabeth, the relationship you had with the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and new champion Hulk Hogan, I must reiterate, this had to be one of the most difficult moments of your entire life. What are you thinking about?
Hey, Sherry! About her opinion. What do you think, Miss Elizabeth? Your mega powers exploded right in your face tonight, didn't they? Well, let me tell you something. In my opinion, the best man didn't win that match.
What do we have here? What do we have here? I'll tell you what we have here, Miss Elizabeth. Yeah, what we have here is the only reason I'm not the World Wrestling Federation champion at this time. Yes, yes, no. True, right there, yeah. I just said it the way it was, yeah. And you know the reason that I am not the champion right now, Miss Elizabeth? Because you distracted me, yeah, you did.
No,
you distracted me. Yeah, you did. You distracted me, didn't you, Miss Elizabeth? And I am the World Wrestling Federation champion. I should be. And you, no, shut up. Shut up right now. Yeah, I'll tell you something right now, yeah.
Please.
No, please, nothing. You shouldn't have done that, Miss Elizabeth. You shouldn't have done that. Yeah, you're hurting. I'm hurting, too. I'm hurting, too. I'm hurting, too. Oh, should I do about you, huh? I'll make sure that Miss Elizabeth and that pretty face doesn't mess with my matches anymore.
Please, man.
I'm going to do that right now. I'm going to do it right now. Liz, are you all right? Are you all right? Are you okay? Macho Man! I'm gonna get you, Macho Man! I'm gonna get you! Oh, God, Liz.
I am the genius, Lanny Poffo. That means an awful lot. Not only can I prove I am, but you can't prove I'm not. I speak 11 languages. Escuchen, por favor. Santana comes from Mexico. Yo hablo más mejor. The French I speak is magnifique. They told me in Paris. My Italian's molto bene. I learned when I was 3. I speak Latin, Greek, and Russian, Hebrew, and Portuguese. I speak Swedish and Norwegian. And I'm learning Japanese. Aside from my intelligence, I'm cunning as a rat. And I shall put these attributes to use upon the mat. I remind the competition and every wrestling fan, behold, the genius Lanny Poffo, the world's smartest man.
Here on, Bobby the Brain Heenan was a very active individual at WrestleMania 5, active indeed in the matchup between Ravishing Rick Rude and the Intercontinental Champion, the Ultimate Warrior, but he paid for it.
Oh, out of the corner, great presence of mind. Rude with a desperation move right there, saving himself from the Warrior.
Quick thinking or it would have been curtains right there for the Ravishing One.
Both of these guys are hurting, Gorilla. Oh,
perhaps a rude awakening. The Warrior's got his hands locked up in there. He's going to power out of it.
Nobody's ever did that to Ravishing Rick Rude.
Absolutely not.
Imagine the psychological devastation.
He's playing with his mind right now, and Rude wants out of there.
That's the wrong place to go with the Warrior. This guy'll take it anywhere, in the parking lot. He likes it outside the ring.
Warrior's shoving him right back in there.
You know, Warrior's had a lot done to him, too. He ain't got as much energy.
Either one of these guys are ripe for the pickings right now. Oh, 360 by Rude. And look at Heenan. He doesn't know what to do.
Can you blame him?
No.
Oh, the preparation, the dream.
Suplex from the outside. Look at Heenan. Grabs the leg of the Warrior. He's holding on.
He did it. He did it. I called it, Matsu.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I said they'd outsmart
this bout.
Smart him, Gorilla.
Referee did not see Heenan's actions from the outside.
Oh!
And Heenan now caught inside the ring.
Look at this, Gorilla. How can Rude enjoy his new title? Look what's happening.
He deserves it, doesn't he?
Whoa! Yeah, well, I'll tell you this, Bobby the Brain Heenan doesn't mind paying McMahon if he gets his results.
Ravishing Rick Rude, the new Intercontinental Champion.
Feeling all over, don't it?
Yeah, real warm. Like maybe you're coming down with some sort of violent sickness.
Thank you. At this time, I would like to present to you the future World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, the Twin Towers.
The future Tag Team Champions, is that the way you introduced the Twin Towers?
That's the way I heard it.
I'll tell you what, that would be some matchup.
Demolition against the Big Boss Man and the Huge Akeem.
Possibly the largest and most awesome
know, brother, that's twice you've been right on the money this week. Because you're right, this is the most awesome tag team ever assembled in the history of the World Wrestling Federation. And yes, they are the future tag team champions. Because you know, brother, when you leave a loaf of bread out on the table too long, it gets stale. And what we need around here is a breath of fresh air. And that's in the person of the Twin Towers, Daddy.
Tell me something, brother boss man. Back in Cobb County, Georgia, what did you do to men who painted their faces all up?
You mean like Demolition? Oh, yeah. The man with painted faces, swelled up bodies, wearing leather and spikes. Well, let me tell you something, little man. You're not going to be able to use them spikes very well with your hands cuffed behind your back. Because one size fits all. We cuffed them all, we beat them all. You'll be no different. We will be World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions before it's over with, boy.
And Brother Akeem, what did you do to him back in deepest, darkest Africa?
We know, brother, some people pick pockets, some people pick apples. The Twin Towers, when we meet Demolition, we're going to pick the tag team titles from around their waist. The Twin Tower way!
Look at this. Celebration going on. However, that will be one we want to keep our eyes on.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's take you back to WrestleMania. We shall show you highlights, or lowlights, if you would, in the matchup involving Jake the Snake Roberts and Andre the Giant.
Both sticking a finger in each other's face here.
If I can read lips, I think John Studd's giving Andre a little law and order.
Sure is. The music you hear in the background could mean only one thing. About to make his way down, Jake the Snake, along with Damien.
And his opponent from Stone Mountain, Georgia, weighing 249 pounds, Jake the Snake Roberts.
Look at that. Andre just laying all that 550 pounds on Jake. Look at that, driving it in, Gorilla.
John Studd laying a count on him here.
But he's breaking before the five. He's not breaking any rules.
He is.
He's taking full advantage of him.
Look at those two ham hocks right around the neck of Jake. Got up to three count, perhaps four. Look at that, between the two of them, you can't even see the snake. And look at this, unloading now, Jake the Snake with... He's hooked in the ropes. He's in no man's land right now. What's Jake going to do here? Is he going to go for the bag, or is he going to lay some shots in? There's no way Andre can get out of there by himself.
He's choking on his own now.
There's the bag right there. Jake, go get it.
Why, Gorilla? That's not fair.
He needs an unfair something or other.
Oh, so it's, yeah, you admit it then. Man against man, not man against man and beast.
Well, it still makes it two against one, doesn't it?
Look at this. Now, why is Studd getting on Andre's case?
Because he won't let the guy get back in the ring.
It's his prerogative.
He's supposed to go to a neutral corner, and if the guy gets counted out, he gets counted out. If he can get back in, he gets back in.
Yeah, but if the guy's trying to get back in, you can knock him back off if he's daydreaming, as you like to say.
Heenan screaming, oh! Jake has got the bag. He's got Damien. He's headed around the corner with it, on his way up. And Big John Studd right there to meet him.
Good.
What is that? Andre just nailed Big John Studd, and John Studd returns a favor. I don't expect to see anything like this. And Jake is untying off from the outside, the million-dollar man. Where's DiBiase going with
that? Oh, I love it. DiBiase's made it a fair match.
Look at this. Jake right after him, right on his tail. And now Andre going after Studd. And Jake caught up with the million-dollar man and stopped him.
We're getting a lot more than we bargained for here, Gorilla.
We certainly are.
We're getting Andre the Giant against Big John Studd.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear from Big John Studd, who has a few things to say directed toward one Andre the Giant.
B-5-0 from Andre the Giant. When we met in WrestleMania 5 in the center of the ring and our eyes locked, the whole world could see that Big John Studd is every bit of a giant as you are. And when I looked in your eyes, Andre, I saw you flicker. I saw you start to flinch. I saw you feel that the legend of Andre the Giant is threatened. And when I turned my back and you grabbed me and you choked me down, that told me what kind of giant you are. That told me you're a giant with a real big yellow streak running down the center of your back. And when we meet, Andre, and we will meet in the center of the ring, I will pick you up, all 500 pounds of you, and slam you to the center of the ring, Andre. And then I'll cover you, and it will be 1, 2, 3, and that's the end of the legend of Andre the Giant.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. About to enter the ring.
Don't get so hot, Jesse. Cool down.
Mr. Fuji.
I'm real hot,
from
McMahon.
From parts unknown, weighing 291 pounds, the Barbarian.
291 pounds, and this man can move
from
that 291 pounds.
Weighing 232 pounds, Ricky.
Put the quietus on him, or what?
I think he's trying to put the hex on the Barbarian, but I personally don't think it's going to work.
He bounced off the Barbarian and hit Ataki right between the eyes. But speaking of hitting him between the eyes, there's an individual waiting in the wings who's looking forward to doing just that.
Oh, Barbarian, you like to listen to Master Fuji. He tells you about pain and torture and hurting people. Well, let me tell you something, baby. You better be able to take it as well as dish it out. Because if you two jokers want to come under me, I'm going to roller above you like a steamroller.
You know, McMahon, there's a guy that isn't all quite there.
Yeah, I think you're right. What a mouth. Oh, no! Did you see that? An unbelievable maneuver by the Barbarian, who kicked his opponent on the butt of the chin and knocked him all the way outside for a loop.
And that takes power, believe me, to be able to put a man with one foot right over that top rope.
Ataki somehow miraculously getting back up. Oh, no, that
And look at
man.
That forearm bringing him right back into the ring the hard way.
No mercy at all. One chop into the pectoral area, knocking Ataki down.
I know for sure now that Neidhart isn't all there, because I can't imagine anybody wanting a piece of this guy.
I can't. I can imagine Neidhart. He's not afraid of anyone or anything. Look at that. Ataki bowled over from the top rope. A cover of sorts, but nonetheless, a three count. What an athlete this
guy. Here is your winner.
Shoulder knocking Ataki down. There's the boot right over the top rope. Shut up, McMahon, I'm talking. And there's the clothesline off the top. And there's your winner. Yeah, we're going to the event center.
I am the genius, Lanny Poffo, a title self-proclaimed. Yet who would dare to say I'm not appropriately named? No longer will I cast my pearls upon the ebbless tide. The secrets of my flaming soul shall never be denied. I am wisdom, strength, and courage. A stunning combination. Feel my presence in the World Wrestling Federation. I'm free to step inside the ring and leave my ghastly trail of innocence corrupted on a grim judicial scale. For I shall be a tyrant at the sounding of the bell, more vile than the putrid slime that lines the gates of hell. I remind the competition and every wrestling fan, behold the genius Lanny Poffo, the world's smartest man.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, my guest at this time, from New Zealand, Luke and Butch, the Bushwhacker.
Luke and Butch, take a look at him. I love these guys. How big is
Look at this, the kids are doing it.
Yeah, why not?
The adults are doing it.
Oh, the big kids are.
All right, gentlemen, I welcome have you aboard this week here at the World Wrestling Federation. Let's talk tag team action. Here is a quote from Bobby the Brain Heenan. He has told me that the Bushwhackers don't belong in the same state, city, building, or arena with his Brainbusters, Butch.
Whoa! Whoa, Mean Gene! As you well know, Bobby the Brain Bloody Heenan is well known for his big bloody mouth and his Brainbusters. Tully Blanchard and Ed Anderson are certainly following suit. And you know, Mean Gene, they think they're so great out there and they say they operate like bloody machines. But you know what's going to be so interesting, Mean Gene? You know what's going to be so great?
What?
When those bloody, what is it, Brainbusters machines get mixed up in the Bushwhackers wacky machine.
All right, Luke, I'm very curious. What do you think of Bobby the Brain Heenan?
The Brain? Mean Gene, the time has come for surgery.
For surgery? What is he talking about?
Brain surgery.
Come to you from Glens Falls, New York, Tony Schiavone and Lord Alfred Hayes. And if there's a determination about Tito Santana, and there's always has been one, it's even more so now. Now, as of a WrestleMania, of course, we all witnessed Rick Martel walking away from ringside and then talking to Gene Okerlund afterwards, Lord Alfred, about the fact that he was, in his opinion, carrying Tito Santana all these years.
Yes, there was definitely a dereliction of duty there. And a breakdown between these two really is a catastrophe, you might say, in the ranks of the World Wrestling Federation. But now Santana is strictly on his own. He might be better off for that. I really don't know. Time will tell, of course. But definitely Rick Martel has split up, and Rick Martel is going to go his own way. And we shall have to see what happens to him.
Certainly very upsetting news for many of the fans of Strikeforce, because they were a great tag team, and obviously now with what has happened in WrestleMania, that is all by the wayside. And certainly a very fierce look on the face of Tito Santana when he came to the ring also, and certainly this rift is on his mind as he kicks away from Iron Mike Sharp, and he's ready to fight, and Sharp backs away to the ropes.
Yes, he is. You can see that in his whole posture. His attitude seems to have changed. He seems to be more into his wrestling now. Now he's only responsible to himself, and I think he's going to take full advantage of that fact. And he's against tough opposition here against Iron Mark Sharp, a very wily veteran wrestler who knows his way about the ring and a powerful man indeed.
Good side headlock from Santana now. Sharp goes down. Santana hits the ropes. Leapfrogs over. Missing Sharp and a great drop kick. Santana sending Mike Sharp down. And again, Iron Mike Sharp out. Now to the floor as Santana with some great drop kicks put him right to the floor again.
That was very good. Those two drop kicks by Santana. You saw how he is determined. He can stretch that body out once he's... Oh, look at this. Rick Martel.
Here he is. Rick Martel is slowly walking up towards the ring apron, and you can see now that Santana looking at his former partner, at least. And now you hear the chant for Tito Santana. We say former partner, certainly with what we saw and what we have seen as a result of WrestleMania, they will never get together again. And Now, it appeared that Santana wanted to take after Martel, and it worked to the advantage of Iron Mike Sharp because he gets him from behind, puts him right to the turnbuckle, and I believe now that that Martel's leaving.
Well, he came out, he did what he wanted to do, and that was to distract Martel. That happened, and now Iron Mike Sharp is on top, could possibly win this match simply because of that interruption by Martel. Santana now has got to take his mind off Martel, get it back into this belt. Once this belt is over, then go back to the subject of Martel. Then think about Martel, and then think about revenge.
Absolutely right. Using the wristband on the back of the head momentarily, but Santana now catches the foot of Iron Mike Sharp and slaps him right in the face. And now Santana certainly borderline irate right here as he works on the midsection, the chest of Mike Sharp, who's tied up on the ropes now. Roundhouse right hand caught him on the head. And now to the other side, sending Sharp in with a backdrop. Tito Santana, after witnessing his former partner Rick Martel coming in, comes out of the ropes with that forearm and pins Iron Mike Sharp. So it may have worked against him. Let's get the official word. There's the official word, and Martel's efforts to blow his concentration out, but really didn't work out at all.
Well, he really got over that, and that was very, very good for him. It shows how he can concentrate. Look at that great Mexican hammer. He takes Sharp down, and obviously now he can relax from this bout and think about Martel and get it back into the ring with him.
Since Jesse Ventura's scoop of last week, we have been speculating as to just whom the Macho Man will appoint as his new manager. Whomever it is,
hey, man, why don't you keep quiet so we can hear what's going on? I want to hear who his new manager is.
Hulk Hogan, you didn't beat me. No, you didn't. You can't beat me. You never could beat me. And you will never beat me. And the only reason that I'm not the World Wrestling Federation champion at this time is because of your manager. It's because of your manager, Miss Elizabeth. I was distracted more than one time. I didn't see it at the time, but I see it now. Miss Elizabeth, I'm done with you. I'm through with you. But Hulk Hogan, I'm not through with you. Oh, no, I'm not. I've got me a manager. I've got me a new manager that is loyal, that is faithful, that doesn't have wandering eyes. It is not possessed by
by lust. I have got me a manager that is more gorgeous than Miss Elizabeth ever could be. Hulk Hogan, I got me a manager that is unbelievably sensational.
McMahon, what a brilliant maneuver by Randy Macho Man Savage. Here I thought he'd name maybe Bobby the Brain Heenan, maybe the Mouth of the South Jimmy Hart, but instead, sensational Sherry, terrific.
Welcome, Sister Sensational, welcome.
Miss Elizabeth. Miss Elizabeth, I know you're out there. And Miss Elizabeth, I know that you can hear me. Miss Elizabeth, I have something to say to you. I am more woman than you have ever dreamed of being. Look at this. Thing to say to you. Can you hear me, Miss Elizabeth? Are you listening to me, Miss Elizabeth? Eat your heart out.
How dare her compare herself to Miss Elizabeth? That makes me sick.
Behold, the world's smartest man, so masculine and proud, the epitome of genius, amazingly endowed, a one-man wrestling renaissance, just let your heart rejoice and bathe in all the luxury of my poetic voice. The best of my competitors are so inferior, I far outthink their greatest thoughts with my posterior, and when the bell has sounded on my stunning victory, I'll view that messy spot where my opponent used to be. The aristocratic pleasure of inflicting so much pain gives rise to so much passion, it is bordered on insane. Although my verse may seem perverse to every foe and fan, I'm still the genius Lanny Poffo, the world's smartest man.
I think ravishing Rick Rude will have the shortest reign of any intercontinental champion in history.
Well, what I can't believe is what a whiner the Warrior is. Why can't he just take defeat in stride like a victory?
Is a certifiable monster.
California, weighing 263 pounds, Mark Ming.
Mark Ming, big 260 pounder.
Look at him next to the Warlord.
He looks small, doesn't he?
Sure does.
We had an occasion to speak with Mr. Fuji prior to the broadcast this week. Here's what he had to say.
Look what I've created, the Warlord. Look at the size of the Warlord. Hey. Only I control him.
How would you like, McMahon, to have your life controlled by him?
I would shudder at the thought.
Mr. Fuji?
I don't know, McMahon. You might be successful.
Really?
Yeah.
I'll try anything once except something like that.
I mean, look how successful the Warlord is.
Yeah, no thanks to Mr. Fuji. Warlord, one of the true powerhouses in the WWF.
And you know what's remarkable about this is Mark Ming weighs 260 pounds. And he looks small.
Yes, he does. Suplex by the Warlord.
You know, the Warlord's showing us some terrific wrestling moves here.
I think he's enjoying his work. Thus far, absolutely no contest whatsoever. A forearm to the small of the back. Ooh, right in the kidney area.
Totally legal, though, as long as it's a forearm and not a closed fist.
Yes, but nonetheless, that has to take its toll. It's like a rabbit punch.
Certainly it does.
Mark Ming, boom, forget about it. The cover, an easy one, two, and three.
I'm impressed. Right there. Beautiful back suplex right there. Followed up by a classic power body slam and an easy win.
Yeah, very easy. A Warlord looking forward to competing on an individual basis in the World Wrestling Federation.
People always ask me questions concerning my degree, because three chevrons in a row should spell out PhD. They assume I went to Oxford where the literary go. That may be true for Oscar Wilde. For me, it isn't so. Get your encyclopedia, select the bookmark L, and look up Lincoln, Abraham, and read it well. I am of the same alumni as our 16th president, and when I wear my cap and gown, I proudly represent my beloved alma mater runneth over my poor cup. It's L-I-N-C-O-L-N. Now go and look it up. And when your homework is complete, then you will understand I am the genius Lanny Poffo, the world's smartest man.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest at this time, bigger, better than ever,
and eyes out for your man.
True or false?
Oh, yeah, he does.
Let's make a reputation.
All right, Big John Studd, you have returned to the World Wrestling Federation. Certainly, you are a giant in this great organization. I've watched your matches, and as of late, since your return, John Studd, I'll pay you the compliment. I'll tell you this. You are better than ever.
Well, I feel better than ever. You know, I spent a lot of time away from the ring, which I missed, but I knew I had to get healthy. I got big. I got strong. I spent hours in the weight room. I spent hours on the mat. And you know what? When I got back and I got rid of the weasel, that made me feel good. And then when all these beautiful people got behind me, they are giving me the strength and the confidence to win the Royal Rumble. And now I've got bigger and better things ahead of me.
You know, Big John Studd, I must say you've unloaded a little excess baggage when you terminated Bobby the Brain Heenan as your manager, but you have privately stated to me you want to prove once and for all that you indeed are the only giant in the World Wrestling Federation.
I'll state it right now. I am the giant of the world of professional wrestling.
Liar.
And you, Andre, every time I look in your eyes, I can see the fear in them. Every time somebody mentions Big John Studd to you, you start to tremble. Well, you got a lot to be afraid of. 380 pounds, 6'10", and I'm coming straight. Do you understand, Andre? Straight at you, and I'm going to show you what fear is all about.
All right, I thank you. Fighting off a pretty big chunk at the eighth wonder of the world, Big John Studd has got his sights set on Andre the Giant. Oh, yeah.
Hey, Warrior, look at all this gold. Look at this beautiful gold, and it belongs to the Bobby the Brain Heenan family and ravishing Rick Rude, and there's nothing you can do about it.
That's right. I won the title at WrestleMania 5. And I plan to keep it as long as I'm alive.
Laughter is not the key for the disease that you have to contend with, Rick Rude and Bobby the Weasel. The wildness of this Ultimate Warrior is going to eat you alive. There will only life until I take the Intercontinental.
Terry Daniels.
Don't tell me the Slickster is going to take on Daniels. What is it, Jeff?
No. Sit back, McMahon. Enjoy this.
Enjoy what?
Listen.
Right now, I want to introduce the Slickster's latest protege, Rick Martel.
What? How do you like that, McMahon? I pulled another one over your eyes.
Rick Martel is managed.
You know, McMahon, I always knew there was a little bit of soul in this guy, even though he's French-Canadian.
I can't believe it. The Slickster managing Rick Martel.
Now watch his career take off. Don't be so irritated, McMahon.
It took off all right. It took off at WrestleMania when this man took off and left Tito Santana alone in the ring by himself.
He had every right to.
Every right.
Every right. Didn't you see Chico flagrantly hit his partner with that flying elbow?
I can't think of any right. Look at this maneuver. Oh, is he ever proud of himself?
Can I use a pun? Little slick, wasn't it?
Uh-huh. Yeah, a little slick. Tito Santana, no doubt. I have a few comments.
Martel, you left me in WrestleMania 5 to fend for my life. Now you've even gone lower by hiring Slick as your manager. Whatever your plans are, I'm going to see to it that they come to an end. Arriba!
Chico seems a bit bitter, McMahon.
Yeah, I think irritated would be like, ooh, what a drop kick by Martel.
Was that pretty or what?
Wow.
You know, Rick Martel was a definite good wrestler before. But now, with Slick's guidance, there's no limit to where Rick Martel's going to go.
Some would say, Jesse, he's already been there. He went to the dogs as soon as he signed up with the Slickster. My goodness, though, he is really wreaking havoc.
You know, McMahon, I'm already noticing an aggressiveness in Rick Martel. I mean, this guy was a great, great scientific wrestler before. Quick, fast, knows his way in and out of that ring. But look at the aggressiveness that the Slickster has already brought out in him. That's the aggressiveness that it takes to become a champion.
Martel with a Boston Crab. That could very well do it. It does indeed. That's it. It's over, Mr. Martel. I think Martel is in the best condition of his life physically.
And by the time Slick's done with him, he'll be able to dance too.
I doubt that.
What's it like to be a genius when everyone's a dope? I have a sense of humor, otherwise I couldn't cope. I'm good at Roman numerals. No, that's not true. I'm great. I use them in my tax returns of 1988. They brought me in for questioning, and wow, were they impressed. Just think what they'd have thought if I had really done my best. I laugh at crossword puzzles in the USA Today. The New York Times is difficult. For me, it's child's play. I tried out once for Jeopardy, but got disqualified. Merv Griffin told me, Lanny, you are overqualified. I remind the competition and every wrestling fan, behold, the genius Lanny Poffo, the world's smartest man.
Beard, he looks like one of my old professors at Yale when I went to school at the School of Journalism and graduated.
Yeah.
This should be an outstanding matchup here.
Jimmy Hart from Seattle, Washington, weighing 248 pounds, Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Garvin against Valentine.
What a matchup this will be, McMahon. You got two tough guys right here. They give no quarter and they take plenty of it.
Jimmy Hart managing Greg the Hammer Valentine. And Mr. Valentine, I would think, would have to call on all of his faculties should he achieve success at the expense of rugged Ronnie Garvin.
I mean, look at this classical matchup. Both men about the same size, both men with similar builds, and both men with a tremendous amount of experience.
And both men who really like to mix it up.
And both have that winner's attitude.
Garvin with a right hand. Another one. Look at that. Valentine back up on his feet, but maybe not for long. Now, why isn't Joey Morella, the referee, stepping in and warning Rugged Ronnie Garvin?
He's doing that just right as we speak.
Those were flagrant closed fists, McMahon. Illegal in wrestling.
Jimmy Hart was distracting the referee from my vantage point.
Oh, come on.
Ooh, what a chop by Val. And another one.
Now, those are legal. That is an open hand, much different than what Garvin was doing
That's
earlier.
That's legal as well.
These two are hammering each other. Oh, my goodness. You know, McMahon, I just wish once in your life you could have taken a blow like that so you'd have some reason to talk about it.
Oh, really?
Just once.
Look at the headbutt by Rugged Ronnie Garvin. Valentine down again.
And the hammer's in trouble. Ronnie Garvin getting the better of the exchange right now. Ooh.
These two are just chopping each other to pieces. Valentine, uh-oh. I don't think it's totally the knee of Garvin.
Definitely, you know what the hammer sets up for on that? His famous figure four. If he hooks that, even Garvin will give up.
Jimmy Hart, yes, here it comes now. Maneuvering it. Leg piece into position.
He's wasting a lot of time. Even either Garvin is hurt or Valentine's wasting too much time.
Small package.
Oh, he got him.
Rugged Ronnie Garvin was playing possum, waiting for Great Valentine to apply the hold. And this place is going bananas. Valentine is shocked.
I gotta classify this somewhat of an upset, McMahon. Here you see the hammer spinning around to go for the figure four. Garvin grabbing the hair, going into the small package and gets the pin.
Let's go to Tony Schiavone. Right now.
Certainly, and you can hear right now the mouth of the South saying no. That was a win for Rugged Ronnie Garvin right here.
What do you say? That didn't happen. That referee was paid off. Ronnie Garvin paid that referee off. There's no way that Ronnie Garvin could ever be great to him about a time. That referee gave me a fast three count. I'm telling you that's what happened.
Now there was a win for Rugged Ronnie Garvin.
Wait a second. You listen to me, Tony Schiavone. I've had a long, illustrious career right here in the World Wrestling Federation being managed by Jimmy, not to the South Hart. And right now, I'm giving Ronnie Garvin the ultimate challenge, a return match. And listen to this, I'm so positive I can beat Ronnie Garvin that I'll put my career on the line. I'll put my career on the line. That means if Ronnie Garvin can beat me, I'll quit wrestling forever.
Wow.
All right, quite a statement at ringside from Greg the Hammer Valentine.
That was one of the most ridiculous comments I've ever heard anyone
style by the barber.
I love you.
You think he really means that, Jesse?
I think he looks honest, McMahon.
Guess this way.
I see.
Going to be cutting in some, maybe a little strutting here.
And if I were Brother Love, I'd be a little concerned, wouldn't you, Jesse?
Definitely. Brutus likes to pick on people he knows he can take.
Welcome, Brother Barber.
I don't think you want to soil his scissors on Brother Love.
Brother Love, I can't believe it. The so-called macho man, Randy Savage, has chosen as his new manager, that sleazy, slimy,
oh my goodness,
overdressed sweat hog.
Whoa, baby!
Who has the audacity to call herself, of all things, sensational, Sherry? can't think of anything sensational about her at all. As a matter of fact, Brother Liv, when I think of Sherry, it's kind of scary. You know, I think that's it. She shouldn't be called sensational. She should be known as Scary Sherry. Scary Sherry.
Oh my
Scary.
Goodness. He's gonna have this capacity crowd going here in the second.
Scary.
He don't like girls.
Sherry.
McMahon, he don't like girls, does
Scary.
He?
Are
you kidding me?
Sherry. Scary.
He's got him rolling. Scary. This capacity crowd.
Scary. Sherry. Scary. Sherry. Scary.
Is that? Whoa.
Sherry. Scary. Sherry.
Sensational Sherry.
Scary.
Kicks having fun. Now, would you be afraid of that, McMahon? Afraid of?
Scary.
Look at the way she's dressed.
Scary.
She is scary, isn't she?
Well,
oh my goodness!
How dare you?
He had it coming.
Smarty pants.
Good.
I am also a lady. And don't you ever
lady?
Forget that. I am always a lady.
Look and out! Randy Savage from behind! He nailed Beefcake right in the back of the head. Look at this, putting those boots to him. Beefcake being pummeled by Savage and by Sensational Sherry as well. Look at that, dropping the elbow in the back of his head. He's unconscious. Ooh, are they going to give him a haircut? Look. They're going to the back, McMahon. Savage ramming the head of Beefcake, the unconscious Beefcake, ramming his head face first into the carpet. I love it. I love it. He's getting done to him what he's done to so many other wrestlers. Turnabout's fair play, McMahon. I love it. I can't believe they're doing this to Beefcake. Coming in from behind. Randy Savage hammering Beefcake from behind. What a combination this is. Macho Man Randy Savage and his new manager, Sensational Sherry. You don't think Beefcake has had that coming after, what, 2 or 3 years of his illegal haircuts? It's about time. My hat goes off to Macho Man and Sensational Sherry. Only they could do it. Good for them.
No ring. No referee.
okay with Rugged Ronnie Garvin, Greg the Hammer Valentine? This guy wants a rematch. He's going to put his career on the line. What do you think?
I will accept it. I'll tell you, I won't bet on a horse. I won't bet on a dog. I won't bet on a football team. But I'll bet on Ronnie Garvin any day.
He's accepted the challenge.
Well, I'll tell you what. Let's see if you accept this, Rugged Ronnie Garvin. You put your career on the line, too. If I beat you, you have to quit wrestling.
Ronnie, what about that?
I'll accept any day. Anything you want.
So there it is. The challenge has been accepted. Both men to put their careers on the line next week right here. It's Rugged Ronnie Garvin against Greg the Hammer Valentine next week.
Time I step into the ring, I wear my cap and gown and destroy my competition, thus increasing my renown. Well, I don't mind your mixed reviews. I simply do not care. But when you call me stupid, that is totally unfair. I am the genius Lanny Poffo. You really should applaud. Instead, you cut me to the quick by calling me a fraud. Oh, yes, those little sly remarks, they make me grind my teeth. There's evil on the surface, and there's poison underneath. But I'll be getting sweet revenge. Yes, everyone will pay. For those who stoop to slander, I will make you rue the day. I'm planning some atrocities for every foe and fan. I am the genius Lanny Poffo, the world's smartest man.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, my guest at this time, the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant, and of course his manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan. Gentlemen, I've heard nothing but complaining and griping. You, Bobby Heenan, saying that Big John Studd is responsible for what happened to Andre the Giant.
You weren't this responsible. It's the worst referee I ever had. I know what I did in that ring and everything was legal. He disqualified me. So don't say he is a good referee.
You know, it's pretty sad when a little pipsqueak like you stands here and thinks you can talk to this man like he's nothing. Well, I don't care, and he don't care if you're 3 feet tall or you're 6'10" like John Studd. Now, Studd was assigned to be a referee because he can't do a good job. That's not our fault. He wanted to stick his nose where it didn't belong, and you saw what happened. Okay, he disqualified this man. Fine, we can take that. But when he put those hands around the neck of John Studd, one thing went into Studd's mind. He knew that he was in the ring with a giant.
You and Mr. Studd.
Where we go from there, I'll tell you one thing. I'm the only giant in a professional wrestling. And I will show him that. And he's going to find it what kind of giant I am. Because I'm coming in that ring. And John Studd, you go to have a giant to see. That's all I have to say.
My reign as Intercontinental Champion has begun. It all started at WrestleMania 5 with the victory over the Ultimate Warrior, and it will continue right here next week as I show the mighty Hercules why I am the Ultimate Intercontinental Champion.
Rick Rude, you weaseled your way into the Intercontinental Championship, but next week, right here, there will be no escape. You will feel the wrath and the power of the mighty Hercules.
Jimmy's done, Bravo's liable to move in next door to you. Tupelo.
Tupelo, Mississippi, that's where you live?
No. Not a lot far from Memphis.
Standing by, ladies and gentlemen, you speak of strong men. You think of Dino Bravo, but you also think of this man, the mighty Hercules.
Dino Bravo, the fact that Jimmy Hart is in your corner now does indeed make you a dangerous man. But look at me and believe me and hear my warning. I am not intimidated, Dino Bravo. If you want to be the world's strongest man, you've got to prove it to me.
And that would be no easy task, although there's some idea of the strength of Mr. Bravo. You know all well the strength, or the lack of it, actually, of Dino Bravo when you try to help him with the alleged world bench press mark.
McMahon, there is no lack of strength in this guy. He could do with one arm what it'd take you two or three arms to do.
Really?
Yeah.
You're probably right.
Hey, I've seen you bench.
Dino Bravo in control until the airplane spin, and his man is not going down.
Brian Johnson is hurting.
He certainly is, and he's hurting a little bit more after that. Bravo hooking the leg, getting the leverage, and gets the three count. His first victory with Jimmy Hart. Hart almost nailed Bravo with a kisser there with the flagpole.
Jimmy's always very zealous.
See that again.
Let's go to the replay. Look at Dino Bravo right here. Beautiful.
Nice. Oh, Brother Love's going to have some very special guests here this week.
Could definitely use some love.
Everybody getting with it here. Luke and Butch, the Bushwhackers. One of the more unusual tag teams in the history of the World Wrestling Federation.
Don't ask me, McMahon.
Oh, all right. Good, good, good look at it. Told they eat those a lot before they go into the ring.
Why, you smell this?
High in protein.
You know, Butch can just kind of grind them up there. You know,
you know, Brother Brain Bobby Heenan has told me that his Brain Busters have something that you do not have. Number one is brain.
Smell that stuff all the way back up here. That's rude. Wow.
Brother Love's.
What the hell are you doing with us now?
Still sniffing his rose.
I'm smelling my rose because you smell disgusting. You know something, Brother Love? I know something that
keeping quiet. Oh my goodness. It's, oh, look what they're doing. They're coming along. It's sardine juice. Oh my goodness. Look at this. Oh, the sardine juice. The rolling one up with a sandwich in his pie. They're stuffing it in his mouth. Luke and Butch are having a lot of fun. The Bushwhackers sharing their sardines with Brother Love. Is that the gratitude they show for being invited on Brother Love's show? Why not? Brother Love laying in a heap of sardine guts. Look at this. Luke and Butch really having some fun out here with Brother Love, the Bushwhackers. Oh my goodness, look at this.
Makes me want to throw up.
Was having a little fun in that limo, huh?
You know, I'll tell you something, McMahon. I think Hogan is a lowlife, and I'll go on record. Not only is he low enough to steal Macho Man's woman, now he's got the guts to invade my domain.
Hollywood?
That's right.
I think there's room for both of you, Jess.
I don't think so, McMahon. If he wants to go to Hollywood, he can come and be my chauffeur driver, my limo.
Well, we are set now for the return matchup from last week. Rugged Ronnie Garvin against Greg the Hammer Valentine. And in this match, both men are laying their careers on the line here. The loser will retire.
That's it. Kaput, right out of wrestling.
I can't believe the gutsy move on both of these wrestlers. I mean, it's all on the line right here.
Well, listen, Garvin certainly should be confident enough. He defeated Greg Valentine 1-2-3 in the middle of the ring just last week.
I don't think that matters, though. That was a lucky move. He probably, Valentine, caught him a little off guard. You can bet the Hammer's prepared for it, and he's showing it right now.
To the buckle, and Valentine moving in. Series of chops here, back and forth. Garvin starting to back Valentine up. You know, a right hand to the forehead, down goes Valentine. We saw the same thing happen last week.
You know, I'm thinking that the Hammer should wrestle this guy. I'm thinking the Hammer should wrestle this guy and not try to punch it out with him. That doesn't seem to work.
Garvin has Valentine right where he wants him. If he gets him up, for, no. Nice maneuver, but no, wait a minute. Valentine goes down.
Valentine within a half a second of retirement.
And Garvin coming on strong here. Jimmy Hart having more than just a few anxious moments out about the ringside area.
Well, you know, there's no advantage either the length that this match goes, because both of these guys love it to be a long match.
Indeed, both in tremendous condition, too. Can't quite get the three count, but nonetheless, that has to start taking its toll on Valentine. He should be losing some confidence now. He is. He's backing off a bit from Garvin.
Yeah, but don't forget, he's got Jimmy Hart there. He's got the brains with him.
Yeah. Which means what?
Jimmy Hart. If he gets in too much trouble, he can bail out. I'm sure they got a plan B and a plan C.
I would doubt it very seriously. Because if Jimmy Hart gets involved in this matchup at all, it will cause Valentine a disqualification. His career's over just like that.
You mean he has to retire if he gets disqualified?
And the loser will be gone. That's all there is to it.
I just can't believe somebody, both of these men, would put their careers on the line.
Valentine, down to the canvas. Come on, Garvin, get down on him. Setting him up now for the big elbow. Yes.
Quit cheering and try being
the cover. He hooks the leg. Picked out by Valentine. And Jimmy Hart really being upset now. Look at that. Garvin with those right hands to the forehead.
And Joey Morello. The referee not even reprimanding him for it.
That's true, he's not.
Whoa, did Valentine catch Rugged Ronnie Garvin there with a chop?
What resiliency in the part of the hammer. Ooh, my.
Now we'll see what Garvin can take.
Valentine to the apron.
He's wasting time. No, he's wasting
too much time. Garvin played possum on him last week, and Garvin's going to beat him to the punch.
And that's a tough position to be put in right there. Slammed off the top rope.
Oh, there's the Garvin stop. Valentine just being
Roberts, you attacked me from behind. Embarrassed me in front of the whole wrestling world at WrestleMania 5. Next week, Jake, you meet me right here, head to head, face to face, and you will pay the price, as does everyone who undermines the million-dollar man.
So Ted DiBiase wants to take a walk on the wild side. The million-dollar man, the man that goes out and buys his own belt because he doesn't want to earn one. Well, I tell you something, DiBiase, you're going to find out I don't do tricks, man. I don't roll over like your boy Virgil does. No, sir. If you want to try something that's fun, try me right here next week.
That music means only one thing, that the Brain is down on the arena floor, leading the way for his man, newly crowned Intercontinental Champ, Ravishing Rick. If he wasn't stuck on himself before, he certainly is now. Thumbs down from those youngsters as we take a look at this capacity crowd.
Cut the music.
He hasn't changed his ways.
What I'd like to have right now is for all you fat, out of shape Syracuse sweat hogs.
Come on.
Keep the noise down while I take my robe off and give the ladies a good look at the new Intercontinental Champion and the sexiest man alive. Hit the music.
And you can bet that that belt is underneath that robe as well. Understand he's been sleeping with it lately. Look at that. To be seen just how long he'll hold on to it.
Soon to be entering the ring area, weighing at 275.
If this were a title match instead of a non-title matchup, it could be all over right here. Listen to the ovation for Hercules. Got that 15-foot chain in there. The Intercontinental Champion at the moment. Even the referee bailed out of there. Looks like Ravishing is leaving.
Just stay here. Get that chain away from him, Rav, or you're going to have a match.
Well, the Brain's saying if the chain doesn't go, they do. Kirk has surrendered the chain. The bell is gone, and we're underway. What a matchup. Main event in any arena, the entire U.S. of A., or anywhere in the world for that matter. What are you waiting for, Hurt? Well, he didn't wait much longer. He must have heard me. Earlier on, we had a chance to talk to the newly crowned champion.
Now you see what a smooth, fluid Intercontinental Champion looks like. Of course, you got a first-hand look at WrestleMania 5, Ultimate Warrior. That was the day I put you to shame, and I became the Ultimate Intercontinental Champion.
Well, those words aren't exactly true as he gets planted right in the kisser with a nice elbow. He did not put the Ultimate Warrior to shame. It was a combination of he and the Weasel who took the championship away from the Ultimate Warrior. But here's a guy right here, Hercules, who can indeed... Well, the title's not at stake. He can't win the title, but he can give you a negative attitude out there. Herc going to the outside. High-risk area for him. Look at the balance. You're looking at close to 300 pounds. Perched up there. Bombs away. Double X handle. He nailed him good. It could be over. No. Rude just squeezed out from underneath there. Power slam by Herc. Two count again, and whoa, the three was coming down by referee Freddie Sparta, but it didn't make it. Well, sometimes, you know, when you win a title, you start gloating about it. You forget about what got you there. And right now, Ravishing Rick is obviously doing just that. Two count once again, and Herc getting a little bit out of shape here. Suplex City coming up. And a beauty. Brain's got to be beside himself. Well, you're not going to beat Ravishing Rick that way, Herc. You got to hook something. Either bar an arm or hook a leg or do something. Irish whip coming up. Downstairs in the breadbasket. Knee lift from the left side. And a clothesline by Herc. Boy, is he unloading. And another one. Almost took his head off with that one. Here comes the backbreaker. Forget about it. Nobody's going to get out of this. Oh, look at that. DeBray reaching in, hooks the leg. Come on, ref, did you see that? Herc going right after the weasel. I don't know whether referee Sparta saw that or not. Referee's down, he's got the chain now. Look out. Tearing out in a hurry. There's Ravishing Rick at the brain.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has disqualified the Mighty Hercules and awarded the match to the Intercontinental Champion, Ravishing Rick Rude.
I don't believe that. Obviously, we're going to have to get some glasses for this referee. All he saw was the Mighty Hercules with his chain. Let's go back and take a look and show you what we're talking about here. Herc had this thing all wrapped up with a backbreaker. Then look at that. The brain reaching in, scoops the ankle of Hercules. I don't believe that decision. Stay with us, folks, because right now we're going to take you to this very special report.
Artist man, so masculine and proud. The epitome of genius, amazingly endowed. A one-man wrestling renaissance. Just let your heart rejoice and bathe in all the luxury of my poetic voice. The best of my competitors are so inferior, I far outthink their greatest thoughts with my posterior. And when the bell has sounded on my stunning victory, I'll view that messy spot where my opponent used to be. The aristocratic pleasure of inflicting so much pain gives rise to so much passion, it is bordered on insane. Although my verse may seem perverse to every foreign fan, I'm still the genius Lanny Poffo, the world's smartest man.
Down in Montlake, Kentucky, there are only two kinds of people, big old goodens and good old biggins. And on that subject, I'd like to introduce to you at this time one of the most popular men in the World Wrestling Federation, Hillbilly Jim.
On this guy, took him under his wing, and now he's one of the superstars.
Here, sir, he'll love you this week. And it looks to me like you've been eating some of Brahma's fixings.
I ain't missed no vittles there, Gene. It's good to be here tonight, good to see you and all these beautiful people. Hey!
You know, Hillbilly Jim, there is a gentleman here in the World Wrestling Federation that I want to talk to you about. He says that he can dance better than you. He says he can sing better than you.
Would you bother to come back
And he's even gone so far as to state that he can play the guitar better than you.
Well, you know, I got to admit that honky-tonk man's a pretty fancy dude. I mean, he's got some pretty fancy clothes. He's got some greased back slick hair. He's got some painted on there sideburns. I realize all that.
You know, he thinks he's, well, you know who.
Well, listen, let me tell you something. Anybody's got any ears that's ever heard that boy sing knows he can't. And there's no doubt about it, that boy cannot pick that guitar. That is not him picking that guitar.
Dancing? He can't do that.
Hey, son, I could cut a rug around you honky-tonk man anytime I wanted to, boy. Look at here, boy. Hey, that's some fast feet there. Ain't that right, folks? Hey!
You know, Hillbilly Jim, at the risk of sounding negative, in the past, the honky-tonk man has been handy on more than one occasion with that guitar of his.
Well, you know, he always gets out here and he talks about how he's going to shake, rattle, and roll and what he's going to do, Gene. Well, let me tell you something, honky-tonk man. You've developed a pretty good reputation of hitting people in the back of the head with that there guitar.
Absolutely.
But that reputation is going to stop right here, son, because you're looking at a 6'7", 300-pound man, and I ain't going to back up one inch from you, boy.
All right. Hillbilly Jim, there's one. It's going to be worth the price of admission alone. I can hardly wait for the matchup between a honky-tonk
man. Hillbilly don't know the meaning of the word backup, Graham.
The big dumb heck from Mudwick.
Doing a little dozy
John Stark. Next week right here, I'm going to destroy you, and I'm going to beat you, and I'm going to pick you up and body slam you, and I'm going to make you bow in front of me.